Hey guys, in today's video, I'll be telling you guys about how I personally prepared for the SAT and how that preparation got me to a score of 1580. Hopefully, what I did can be incorporated into how you are going to study, so hopefully that will also help you get a pretty good score and improve on how you're doing. I honestly feel like the thing that has been most beneficial in my preparation for the SAT has been my academic background. I've always been an avid reader. Growing up, my parents spoke Chinese to me, so I basically learned all of my English through just constantly getting lots and lots of books from my local library and just going through them like there was no tomorrow. As far as math goes, first of all, the SAT goes up to Algebra 2 and maybe a little bit of pre-calc depending on how curriculum works at your school. I took the SAT in August of my junior year, which was August 2018, and by that point, I had already taken Algebra 2 in freshman year, and I took Honors Pre-Calculus in sophomore year, and then by the time I had taken the SAT, I had already been taking AP Calc BC. So I feel like being at a pretty good head start in my math classes really helped me with knowing the math skills necessary. So if you feel like you're not quite at the Algebra 2 level yet, then I would recommend getting some extra tutoring or help just to learn those specific math skills that are taught in Algebra 2. As far as the reading and grammar sections go, as I mentioned earlier, I've always just read a lot of books. So that helped me, one, to be able to read pretty darn quickly, and two, it helped me internalize how grammar and punctuation work. Without necessarily having to memorize rules, I just intuitively learned them. Also, taking AP European History in my sophomore year was also really helpful for improving my skills at reading historical documents and interpreting more old-timey, slightly clunkier styles of English that we're not as used to in the modern day. So if you have those options available to you, definitely get used to reading historical documents, whether that be through a class or just your own practice. In 10th grade, I definitely recommend taking the PSAT. I took it in 10th grade, as I mentioned, without any prior preparation, and I did pretty darn well. I got a 1500, and from that point, I just decided that I was just gonna take the SAT and not bother trying out the ACT. The PSAT can be a really helpful way for you to gauge what level you're at and what type of preparation you might require, or whether you might want to take the ACT or SAT and stuff like that. As I mentioned, I took the August SAT at the very beginning of my junior year, so I just used that summer break to prepare for the SAT. And the preparation I did was doing the Khan Academy daily practice. Khan Academy partnered with the College Board to provide official SAT practice questions that are available completely for free. So I definitely recommend checking out that resource. What I did was about 10 to 20 minutes of daily practicing through just doing those practice questions every single day leading up to the test, except for a couple of weeks that I missed due to travel. And every 2 or 3 weeks, I did a full practice test. I definitely would recommend doing it more often than I did and trying to actually simulate testing conditions by practicing in an entirely silent environment and setting yourself the time limits. I didn't really do that, but you probably should. I got these practice tests from the official College Board SAT Study Guide, which is just a really big book with 8 full practice tests. And these practice tests do cost money if you want to buy the book, but you can also get them for free on the College Board website. You'll just have to print them out yourself. On the practice tests that I did, my scores were usually somewhere around the 1500 range, sometimes above, maybe going up to like 1550. I can't remember the details, but usually above 1500 or like close to 1500. And then I took the actual thing just one time. Honestly, I'm pretty sure I'm never gonna do that well again ever, so I'm out. I don't enjoy the SAT. Peace. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you'd like to see my actual advice video and not just how I personally studied, I will link that in the cards and in the description. I upload new videos every Monday, and my Instagram is at studyquill if you'd like to see photos of my notes and bullet journal. See you next time!